The October edition from the Madison Symphony Orchestra is a Scottish fantasy, at least for part of it. Here to give us a preview of the concert, Maestro John Demain. Good morning.
Hi. Good morning, Amy.
Now, tell us about your guest artist that will be performing for this concert.
James Ennis, absolutely spectacular. He was with us in 2012, and I was so excited by his playing that with this sort of younger generation of new superstars, if we have a great connection with them and they have a great connection with us, I can't wait to get them back so that the audience can get a bigger picture of their whole artistry. And so this time James is going to play the Scottish Fantasy of Brooke, which we haven't played in quite a few years, I think since the 80s.
Wow.
And so this will be great. And of course it's filled with actual Scottish folk tunes, and it's a really substantial virtuoso work which he will just play to perfection.
And so he's kind of covering the fiddle part of it, but it also sounds a little bit like bagpipes.
Well, it has a big orchestra underneath it. You know, it's a big orchestra piece. And so it's a really joyous piece to listen to in all of its movements.
And the concert will begin with a piece by Haydn.
Another work that I've chosen that the orchestra has never played before, Haydn Symphony 85, which was the favorite of Marie Antoinette, I believe.
Wow, that really takes it back.
It takes it back. And a charming piece. And, you know, it's orchestras, the musicians, I mean, Haydn's a wonderful, you know, it's when you love classical music, you love listening to Haydn, but it's a wonderful composer to play because it really demands a kind of discipline from the string section, and they love playing that because it just hones their skills. And of course, he gave us so many delightful symphonies, which was really great.
And then you're going to wrap it all up with the Rachmaninoff.
The last piece he wrote before he died, the Symphonic Dances. Now, this is an interesting one personally for me. I love Rachmaninoff, and I love this piece. But I did it my second year that I was here, and everybody said, are you crazy? This is one of the hardest pieces to play for an orchestra. It's brutally difficult. And we did it. I mean, I rehearsed very slowly, and we had a really good performance of it. But this is a very different orchestra now, you know? So it's going to be very interesting to see how this comes together. You know, I'm anticipating it's going to come together much faster because of where the orchestra is now. And beautiful piece to listen to, and you know, one of the great masterpieces of Rachmaninoff for orchestra.
Well, and everyone brings something different to it too, as you mentioned, with the musicians are changing constantly.
Sure. When you have different principles too, you know. I mean, although I think most of our woodwinds are the same as then. We have a different principal horn than then, and Joe, of course, being, and Cindy Fix, our bassoonist, and Joe Morris, our principal clarinet. Those players are new. Tuba's new, you know, over the years. But then we have some of our, you know, our friends like Mark Fink and Stephanie Judd and John Ailey, you know, and Joyce, who are, you know, have been with me since
now, in the beginning
of my 22nd season this year.
Wow. Well, it's all happening at Overture Hall, the Madison Symphony Orchestra, performing October 16th, 17th, and 18th. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Amy.